Hello friends, in today's video we are going to see three examples for combinational circuit. People who doesn't know what is combinational circuit, a simplest example is combinational circuit will depend only on the inputs and it will not be having any memory elements unlike sequential circuit, and also combinational circuit will depend only on the inputs and present state, which is like you can use like gates and or not. That's all which you want to know about combinational circuit. For further more understanding, please read into some Google. Okay, let's come into these three examples what we have for you guys today. We are going to see three examples. One is adders, another is multiplier, and another third one is mux. So let's start with the mux. Muxing is very easy. The mux is like you will have input, select line, and output. Whenever your select line is 0, your input should be I0, and then if your select line is 1, the input will be I1. That's all. So basically you can write this mux in three different way if you are using combinational circuit in Verilog or in system Verilog. This thing which I am writing is a coding style in system Verilog. Basically what you need to do is, whenever you have an input, you need to use input logic in 0, or input bit you can use, or logic you can use. Logic is these data types of system Verilog I'll teach you later, but basic understanding is logic is four values is possible, 0, 1, x and z. But in case if you had used a bit, it is two variable, which is 0 and 1. That's all. So here we are declaring the inputs and output. Input will be in 0 in 1 select, and the output will be logic out. Here I am telling out equal to cell in 1 and in 0. So here what it means is, if I just leave select, according to system Verilog, this will be calculating this as select equal to 1. If select is 1, then take in 1 value. If select is 0, then take in 0 value. That is what it is explaining. That's all it is about. So it's very simple, right? So in assign, this is one line which we need to do. This is one way of writing. The other way of writing is, you can use always combinational block. So in always combinational block, we need to write like always com begin end, and then we can use if else statement, or we can use a case statement for this particular mux example. So if you are using a if else statement, then you need to do if select equal to 1 tick b1 begin out equal to 1, or you can use like equal to 1 tick b0, then out will be in 0, something like this. We can define the same plain if else condition, so you can do this. So what I had written here is, in case these examples have just one line, right? So in case if you have just one line right like this, you can directly define else out equal to in 0 itself. This will not give you any simulation error or a synthesis error. But in case if you have multi-line, it's you should and you must use begin and end. I would always say, even if it is a single line, use begin and end, which is a better coding practice. In the future you might get some more variable like out equal to in 1, like out 2 equal to into something like that. So that time, instead of writing begin and end, initially itself keep writing begin and end. That is a better coding practice. So the third type of variety is always com case statement. So for case statement, we don't need this begin and end, because the case and the end case itself will understand it begin here and then it end here. That's all we need. So for case statement, we don't need this begin end. And so what we are selling is case select, because select is the thing which is going to decide whether it is in 0 or in 1. So I am telling select. If my select is 0, then it will be in 0. If my select is 1, then it will be in 1. That's all. So let's move on to adder. So for adder, a simple understanding what you need to have is, for adder, in case if we try to add 3-bit number with 3-bit number, then it will become 4 bits, because there will be one more bit which is like a carry bit. For example, a 3-bit maximum value is 7, and so if I add 2 7s, then it will become 14, which cannot be fit inside 3 bits. So we need a 4th bit. That's the reason That is one understanding you need to have before going into adder. So we are going to implement our adder with just A, B, and then sum and carry out. Here we are having, so sorry for that. So our input logic is in 0, in 1, and then output will be sum. Then you need to assign, we are assigning sum equal to in 0 and in 1. In this particular example, I am having the width will be width minus 1 down to 0 and width minus 1 down to 0. So my sum will miss my carry. So in case if it comes 7 and 7, this particular example will give me an answer of 6. That's what I was writing down here. But yeah, so this particular example will give me an answer of 6. The reason is that doesn't know there is another one bit called the carry. That doesn't know that one more bit was left out because of carry. So this is one thing. So I didn't explain what is this parameter until now. So the parameter is nothing but a simple thing where in case if you use a parameter, you can change this during runtime. We can change this in runtime. So that is why we are using parameter later. Now currently I have just a 3-bit number. Maybe in the future I can expect it to change it into 8-bit number or 12-bit number. That time instead of coming and changing in the entire codes, we can directly alter this in the runtime saying that my parameter width will be changed to 16. Then every width will become 16. So that's the reason why we are using parameter. And then I'm using the same parameter here. I'm using it like width minus 1 down to 0. The reason is so whenever you have 3 down to 0, which means 4 bits, so I need my width itself just a 3. So I needed 2 down to 0. How I can bring 2 down to 0? I need to subtract minus 1 width minus 1 down to 0. That is the reason why we are doing this. Cool. And here I explained you in this two different ways, type 1 and type 2, which is like one way is assign statement, another is always combinational statement, which we already see in the MUX example. So that is done. Then type 3 is like we are having an issue with this system, right? Where when a carry is coming, we are missing out the carry bit. So how to capture it? So we can have another one separate thing called carry bit, where in our carry bit we need to use a concatenation operator like this. Concatenate carry out comma sum in 0 plus in 1. Then you will be able to observe that this carry out will become high. For this I have a sample TB had written here. In case if you run this, you will be able to observe. I'm sharing this EDA link with you guys. The scope of this course is not to teach you verification, at least for the time being, but I'll teach whenever possible. Cool. And here if you notice this in 0 in 1 sum is there. So whenever my in 0 and in 1 is greater than 7, the addition of it is greater than 7, my carry out bit is setting. And you can see here it's just a 2 and 5, which is 7. The sum alone is coming. But when it comes here, it is having 5 and 6, which is 11. So my sum is just showing 3, but my carry out is coming out at that time. So we can change this to binary in order to understand better. I forgot how to change to binary. Radix. Yes, I guess this one. Yeah. Cool. If you see here, you will be able to see whenever these two things are more than intended value, then we are getting a carry out bit. That's what we wanted to see. Cool. So the final example what I had shown here is slicing method. So the slicing method is simple, where you can have an internal signal called a full signal or full whatever it is. So this full signal will be four bits long, because even to capture this carry out, everything will be captured with this 4-bit. So I will be assigning inside the always combinational block like full signal equal to in 0 plus in 1, and sum will be full signal of width minus 1 down to 0, which is like 2 down to 0. And then my carry out will be full signal of width, which is bit third alone. So that way we can pass these values into this separately, and then we will be able to understand and capture it. This is another way. So the last one thing which we wanted to discuss today is multiplier. So for multiplier, you need to understand that as I told for adder, here in multiplier, this bits will multiply into 4. Like in case if I have 4 and 4, 4 bits multiplication, then my result will be 8 bits. So here for our particular example, our with this 3. So in case if my with this 3, then it will be 3*3. So it needs at least 6 bits. 3, okay. Please don't mistake, it's like not 3*3. I'm not trying to say it's 9, but I'm speaking in terms of bits. So 3 bits multiplying 3 bits, then we need 6 bits. So here what we are doing is, we here in the, for the input, it is going to be just with minus 1 down to 0, with minus 1 down to 0. But for my output, what I'm trying to do is with *2 -1, which is like 3*2, 6 - 1 down to 0, which is 5 down to 0 will be my product. That's what we are doing here. And then we are just using an assign product equal to in 0*1. That will be all. This is the intended lecture what I was planned for the first part of combinational logic. I do understand people following my lecture in formal verification might think, why am I starting this design course? The reason is this design course will be based for our formal verification tutorial in order to reach a complex design. I was trying to mimic or make a bigger design, but it was taking a lot of time. So I thought organizing and speaking about this digital design course will help in the way. So let's learn or refresh our knowledge about digital design topics too. Design proper, mainly design topics. Then when we are going back to the formal verification, it will be much more easy. Cool. Thank you guys. And the scope of this design course is to reach at least I2C protocol and AXI protocol. Let's work on that and try reaching there. Thank you. We'll meet you in some other video.